Private sector investments into Uganda's electricity transmission segment are in final stages. Private investments into this segment of Uganda's electricity supply industry was one of the introductions by the amendments of the Electricity Act 2022. Before this amendment, the Act had placed development of electricity transmission infrastructure solely under the Uganda Electricity Transmission Company Limited. 2 years ago, the government signed a memorandum of understanding with the British investment firm Gridworks to pilot these investments in four substations, among them Tororo, Mbarara, and Mirama Hills. Gridworks country director for Uganda gives an update of what has transpired since then.
As you'll appreciate, these are large projects with in a very nascent field, not just for Uganda but for Africa. I think outside of South Africa, there probably is no country that has yet achieved private investment in transmission. So Uganda would be the first, and that's a great step forward. Why it takes time is because we have to develop all the studies for the substations and the infrastructure. We have to do feasibility studies, we have to do designs, we have to do environmental and social impact assessments, we have to develop the transmission services agreement and negotiate that with the governments. These processes take time, and this is, in our case, it's taken us 2 years.
Private investment in the transmission segment presents an opportunity for both investors and the government to improve the country's national grid and unlock demand for the utility.
It is a combination. We have two types of projects in IPTs. There's greenfield, there's brownfield. The brownfield simply means that you come and invest in an existing substation to increase the capacity. That I know is ongoing now, at least it's a negotiation in that direction. But the greenfield is completely new infrastructure that did not exist. That means building a transmission line that did not exist, building substations that did not exist. Those are the two opportunities that actually exist. And I know that there's interest in both. Now, each of those presents opportunities. One, the brownfield is good for ordinary expansion of capacity. Okay? That is the substation exists, but you're simply expanding from the capacity to deal with the demand. The second one, which is greenfield, is to service unserved areas. If you have a constraint of transmission, for example, to Mbale or the Elgon area to evacuate power plants in the Mount Elgon region, then you build a new transmission line, you build new substation, that is considered a greenfield investment. So those two opportunities exist, and I know that investors are interested in both.
However, private investors are keen to avoid the impact of their investments on the end user tariff, as it had been argued that this could end up making electricity more expensive for the consumers.
Transmission and distribution infrastructure in Africa. We are working on a project in Uganda as a pilot for private investment in electricity transmission. This is an exciting opportunity because in the past, transmission was only allowed for public investment by the government. But we see that the market is big, sometimes there are bottlenecks in electricity transmission, and therefore having private sector players like ourselves be involved in private investment in transmission systems is a great plus for the country. Uganda has been a good market for Gridworks in the sense that the market already has developed regulation which is quite advanced as compared to the rest of the African countries.
Up to $60 million is expected to be invested by Gridworks in this pilot stage, after which it will be mass rolled out to other investors. This is expected to accelerate investment into the segment of industry that has previously affected and suffered from inadequate funding. The government estimates that about $4.5 billion is required to be invested in the national grid by 2031 to facilitate full grid access to all Ugandans.